Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I'll be talking about practical approaches in Down syndrome. Just a bit about the epidemiology. The estimated incidence for Down syndrome is about 1 in 1,000 in live birth worldwide. And the most important thing for me is that it's the most common genetic condition with intellectual disability. I will give you a little bit about our stats. In Doran Ginza Hospital, we have currently, from 2011 until 2016, excluding the others, we have diagnosed 169 patients. 33% from the mothers who are more than 38 years. I will not really, I know you are all, you know Down syndrome, but it's important to understand the problems of children with Down syndrome. The most common ones is hypotonia. 50% of them, they have congenital heart disease. And it's also important to know that all of them, they will have intellectual disability, but with a variability when it comes to cognitive. And the otitis media and the obstructive sleep disorders and the eye disorders. I will not finish the list, it's just to understand. But this is also very important. Remember, kids with Down syndrome get all the things that other kids get too. So, because these kids, they often get labeled and people just see the Down syndrome. And some medical conditions are overrepresented, for example, the respiratory tract infections, and most are treatable disorders, but if undiagnosed, they will impose additional but preventable burden of secondary handicap. Do not over-syndromize, and presentation may be different because of the behavior. When we look at the management in South Africa, there is no specific guidelines for Down syndrome. Management is relatively decentralized with few centers that render the multidisciplinary care. And the majority of us in the country, we do not have the genetic services. Guidelines are based, most of the guidelines people that are using, they are based on the American Academy of Pediatrics in UK. In Eastern Cape, there is no genetic counselor or fetal medicine department at all. And in my clinic, I have three members of staff. Actually, I have a care coordinator that is full-time employed by the PE Down Syndrome Association. I also have a lady cytogeneticist who's employed by Path Care. Interesting enough, she's the person who started the clinic as a cytogeneticist, it's fine. And we rely on support from Gauteng and Cape Town. It's important for care to understand that poor socioeconomic status will lead to poor care, health system that is not structured, poor maternal education and awareness, and no protocols and ill-defined referral system. When you consider the management, care coordination and continuity of care becomes important, and it has to be comprehensive. When you talk about comprehensive, that also includes, is not limited to health. It also includes other sectors as well. And you have to start the collaboration earlier on. And you must capacitate your primary health caregivers because they will be looking after this child for long term. So they need to be capacitated. And also the healthcare workers, because if people, they do not have knowledge, you need to capacitate them so that in future you can down refer and not have overburden. Communication becomes critical. In addition to Road to Health booklet, you also have to develop a case management plan for an individual patient. On consideration in management, early intervention makes a huge difference in maximizing the individual potential. Early childhood is critical time for development. Medical management, home environment, education, vocational training should be addressed early. Linkages of care, you must know your community, you must know the NGOs that are available in your community, and also the specific conditions organizations, education as well becomes a huge problem. In our genetic clinic, I won't get into details, but the most important thing, when I started, most of the kids were really diagnosed very late. And then I collaborated with National Department of Health, with genetic department. We did a comprehensive cleaning just to diagnose, to know the dysmorphology. And then after that, I was flooded with a lot of referrals. So what we do, we just review the phenotype. We send our bloods to pet care that we have collaborated with. And then we do counseling. But most importantly, because we have a care coordinator, we link the patient immediately and we provide pamphlets. We show them little exercises to improve tone because they not always have the OT. And then we do the screening and we write a letter immediately for SASSA so that when they come for the results, they can come with a form. We minimize the timing of the patient going up and down. And then on site, we have a cardiologist. They do same day, they echo, and then manage. So these are some of the important things. The important thing is to discuss, continuous discussion and counseling, and the screening, anticipatory guidance is important, and early intervention. When they are 4 to 6 years, we started to talk about the schooling, and then we also supported by one group that is called Early Inspiration, which supports the mothers with the early stimulation earlier on. So that is the management. For the 7 to 18 years, we start to introduce adolescence issues, especially the menstruation in girls, and then we also try and link them to care. Our challenge is really for the fact that we do not have these services. If there's an X, there's always a Y, and there's always a solution. So we don't have fetal medicine, but we capacitated healthcare workers. And on addition, we work with another obstetrician with special interest in fetal medicine who provides us with support. Okay. No genetic lab services. We collaborated with PetCare. And we lost our speech therapist. Now we do the group speech therapy sessions. And this has helped for us, okay. What can be done? Education targeted at primary caregivers, development of protocols and clearly defined follow-up, public awareness, establishment and utilization of multidisciplinary approach. Creativity is very important, intersectoral collaboration and advocacy, especially when it comes to the schooling. That is very important. Every child has a right to basic education, to any care. Thank you.